What's up, everyone? Welcome back to Sims Proving Every Day. I'm Gina, and today we are doing a speed build. It's been a minute since I've done one of these, so I'm really excited to get into it. Remember, if you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up. Help your girl out, please and thank you. So this is the house that my werewolf family is going to be moving into when they move to Copperdale. And there's really not much to say about it other than the normal stuff of it always takes me forever to choose the doors, windows, walls, and floors that I want. In this house, I try to get out of my comfort zone. I've got weird things that pop up a little bit later. And also, of course, all the recorded video clips are sped up quite a bit, but the music is not. So the placement, like thunks when you place something or delete something, those are not going to be in sync. But I'm just not feeling that fancy to try to get everything tall, line up, or get new music. And one last thing is, you'll notice that I have it set to an arts center. That is so when I go in and finish up with my werewolf family, some other jackass doesn't move into the house before me. So I will change it back to residential as soon as we move in. The unfurnished version will be up on the gallery pretty quick here, and then I'm not going to put the furnished version up until we move in and get furnishings. All right, enjoy! And here we are for the tour of Howell Place. This is the unfurnished version that the family will be moving into, and I chose to do it this way because most of the time when you move into a new house, you don't buy it pre-furnished. Sometimes you do, but most often you don't. This is what it looks like from the front. The side, and I apologize, this is kind of like a hilly area, so the camera's gonna get all freaking crazy on me. And that is the back, and there's the pool with the turtles in it. Other side, and back to the front. Alright, so if we go down to the first floor, when we walk through the door, to the right is going to be the living room, and then through this archway is a bedroom and a full bathroom. And if we keep going straight, this will be the dining room. I'm not sure I'm sold on this light yet. It doesn't really match anything else in the house at this point. Kitchen. And I decided on the light blue cabinets to go with the small little tiles in the walls. This is the staircase down to the basement. And then if we go to the left, this is going to be my office. A half bathroom. Toilet is on that side. And this is going to be mine and Lou's bedroom. And I know I've mentioned it before. I hate the carpet in The Sims 4. Why can't we get any new carpet? And this is our bathroom. And I tried to do the shower like I did in one of my other houses, where I dropped the platform down so it was like a step down into the shower, but for whatever reason it wouldn't work, probably because I have the basement attached to it right there. Okay, so if we go downstairs to the basement, this will be the workout room. This will be our safe room in case we have any werewolf urges come back. And then this is gonna be where the garden is. And I know this is a little bit weird having a skylight like that in the front yard, but I was trying something new. So there it is. And then at night, this kind of looks cool because it reflects the stars. Even though there are actually walls there, it doesn't look like it. Okay. When we go upstairs, we enter into this room, which is going to be like a family game room. And I have done this for a reason. I know it looks weird, like the colors and stuff. This is going to be like a retro, like 50s, 60s room when I am done with it. Through these doors is just a... This is going to be like the skill room where the chess table and bookcases and stuff like that is. And another full bathroom. And then this is Luna's room. I absolutely love this wallpaper. And her little bathroom. That doesn't have a toilet! Oh, shame, shame. How did I do that? Uh-oh. Okay, well, we gotta put a toilet in there. Do I want to... This is gonna be weird. Where am I gonna put it? Okay, I guess I will just shift everything down. coming. Toilet. I can't believe I did that, you guys. That should be okay. If for any reason she can't get to it, then of course I will have to reevaluate. Okay. And then this will be her closet. I don't think I'm gonna take the time to give her a full, like, special closet because it, I don't know, after you use the pieces so many times, you're kind of over it. And I actually had built a closet for me and Lou, and I know I said I wasn't going to. Oh, and the tree's coming through. That's awesome. I know I said I wasn't gonna, like, put any detail in yet, but I felt like I had to do that for some reason. Okay, let's get these trees out of here. There we go. Okay, so back up to Luna's room. There's a little ladder here. The original house that was here had like a little tiny third story room, and I really liked that idea, so of course I had to go and make it bigger. So this is Luna's like little getaway room where I'm going to put her desk and a couch and maybe a mini fridge, that kind of stuff. So there it is. I hope you like it. It will be on the gallery. My origin ID is Gina S-P-E, G-I-N-A S-P-E. Go over, download it, save it, love it, comment on it, and most of all, enjoy it. Thank you so much for hanging out with me today. I really do appreciate it. Remember to like, subscribe, hit that notification bell. Questions, kind comments, and feedback are always welcome. And remember, be a nice human. Bye, everybody.